Hi, I'm Kelsey. Today, I'll show you how to draw a pattern for the bottom of this bag. If you know this, you can make it the way you want. And second, I'll take a look at stiffeners and reinforcement that I use, and their features. You can be able to design many kinds of bags if you apply this. Let's say you want to make a bag of this size. And decide the size of this part. Usually, I make 10mm, but since I want to make the inside space maximum, so I'll do 5mm this time. Make the front, bottom, side patterns. And I'll make a 5mm grooves for the sides and bottom connection. Let's zoom in this part. Mark 5mm, and then make 5 this side too. Leave those triangles on both ends and get rid of the rest. Do the same thing for the parts that connect the sides and bottom. If you decided to make 10mm instead of 5, then make this part 10. Then we get this. If you designed round corners, cut with the same size as the main body's corner, like this. And in case you want to make a bag with two sections, double those parts. Very simple. Okay, I hope that I explained it clearly. Let's skip to the next. Let's take a look at stiffeners. There are many different kinds of reinforcement depends on what kind of a bag you are planning to make or where you want to use it because features are different. People use different ones in different places. So you try first and decide. This is the one that I made only with vegetable leather. And this one is made with various stiffeners and leather. There are factors with different materials, but the impression is definitely different. And also, this one is heavier. This is the front of the main body. I'm gonna use those stiffeners for a somewhat hard and handy bag. This is some sort of a compressed sponge with one side sticker. In Korea, it is called insole or lava. And I searched on Google. It was Eva high density foam. And I'm not sure if they are one side glued like this or not. Anyway, this is used for volume. Very flexible and there are various thickness choices. You can use this for a big shoulder bag or something for flexibility and shape. This is Weptex. In my experience, Weptex, Bontex, and Texan are similar. This is paper material but very compressed and tough. So this is ideal for solid handbag. Also various thickness choices. This one is just simple lining. Bottom part. This is part that requires strength, so I want it to be thicker than other part. SL. This is called a synthetic leather. Feels like leather but very light. And some sort of gauze is attached on both sides. I use this on the body of a bag when the leather is too thin. VXP. This feels like stiff fabric but flexible and resilient. I almost always use this one whether it is a bag or a small wallet. Very light. I'm gonna put VXP and lining fabric only for the sides. I think there are no rules of using this one on here or there. Just try and feel those and then decide where to go. I'll do bonding. I like water-based ones. Odorless and adhesion is pretty nice. But when I work with stiffeners on leather, a rubber-based one is necessary. To make finishing easier, you need to apply glue thoroughly, especially the edges. Now let's attach those side and bottom part. Then stitch. I stitched all along and prepared the rest. Let's attach those and stitch. Now the final stitch is done. I'll finish with those. I made this content to share how to draw a pattern for your own design. But if you want the dimensions of my pattern, I'll send them to you. Leave your email address on comment. And if you liked my video, would you press like? That'll be great. Thank you!